All fans in attendance, please rise and join us for prayer, followed by the playing of our national anthem. Let's pray. Dear Lord, please bless today's game, our opponent, our team, and all watching. Thank you for the opportunity to compete, and may what happens on the court go for your glory. Please keep everyone safe from injury and illness. We pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Happy holidays here in La Mirada, coming from Chase Gymnasium. Jake Macias here joining with you on the stream. We got a good one. Got Biola going up against Art U. And we'll get things kicked off shortly. We'll start here with Biola Eagles, currently 5-5. You know, they have a balanced record, obviously 5-5. They enter the game with confidence and a determination to break away from the middle of the pack. The Eagles aim to showcase their talent against a great defensive team here in RU. And keep an eye on players like Jordan Rabe, Layla Walker, who have consistently delivered each game so far this year. Those are my two players to watch for Biola. And let's talk about the starting lineup for the Eagles as well. Number two, Layla Walker, who I just mentioned. Number three, Natasa Radovich. Jessa Thurman, number five. And then number 12, Alyssa Kubo, getting the start for the Eagles. And then finally, number 23, Jordan Rabe. And then taking a look at Academy of Art and the Urban Knights. Currently 2-6, so they're facing, you know, a challenging season so far, looking to redeem themselves, hungry for that redemption. And, you know, despite their recent struggles, the Knights, you know, they're skilled. They have got a skilled roster, and they're ready to turn the tide today. Look out for players like Alba Yuso and Lucia Ravenga as they strive to lead their team to victory and prove that they are a force in the PacWest Conference. And looking at starters here for RU, we got number zero, Lucia Ravenga, number one, Anna Fornells, number five, Maddie Morrow, number 11, Alba Rivera Ayuso, and then number 21, Yasmin Sifawi. So it should be a good one today, you know, a lot to talk about. First things first, when we look at RU's defense, obviously a competitive team, and they don't really mess around here. I mean, it's just a fact of allowing the offense to work off of the defense. They're able to create those turnovers, you know, with good 8 steals per game. That's one of the better steal statistics in the PacWest, and you know, we just haven't seen too much of that transition from defense to offense, hence their record. So we'll see what they can do here against Biola. Biola scoring right around 55 points per game, but even more of a defensive team than RU. This should be more of a defensive battle, as Biola only allows 59 points per game compared to RU scoring around 65 points per game. So we'll see where the tides turn in this one. Should be a fun one again. Jake Macias on the call. Thank you for joining us here at Eagles Broadcast. If you want to send a shout out over at eaglesbroadcast@gmail.com, I'd love to read it out. Let me know if you're rooting for a player, a team, a coach, whatever the case is. And again, I'll be happy to read that shout out. It is eaglesbroadcast@gmail.com. So right here we go. Tip off. Jessa Thurman taking it away for Biola. Alyssa Kubo setting up the offense. And here we go. Here on this holiday break. Not too many people in the stands. Everyone's gone on break. As Radovich kicks that one out to the corner, decides to pull the trigger, but a little long. Here comes Academy of Art, interested to see how they'll maneuver the offense here early on. Haven't seen too much of this new team. A lot of freshmen on this team. In fact, three of them who are starting are freshmen for this team. A young squad looking to get a win as that corner three is good. It's Maddie Morrow firing away. So the Urban Knights get on the board right away, 3-0. Backdoor pass. Right idea, but gets away from Thurman. You know, we see a lot of those types of passes from Walker, just perfectly placed, but just a little catches the other players off guard, and that's why there's so many turnovers there. But either way, right idea from Walker. Kick out to the corner. Good defense here from the Eagles. Letting one fly, no good. Rebound Radovich. Here come the Eagles. Giving it up to Kubo up top. Radovich setting the screen. Over to Rabe on the wing. Decides to take it with the left. She's got Thurman for three. Yes. Jessa Thurman letting it fly. An early press here from Biola. You don't typically see that from this squad. Corner three again. No. Offensive rebound. Good pump fake. Driving in. Foul called. And it's going to be a block. So that's Alba Rivera Yuso. The sophomore from Spain getting two free throws of her own. Now, she was one of the players that I had briefly mentioned. She's the leading scorer for this Urban Knights team at right around 11 and a half points per game. This squad, what I've noticed is that they're very evenly distributed in terms of points as that one falls through. You have players like Ravenga, Fornells, all scoring near double digits. Kubo might have twisted her ankle. We're going to have a timeout here. Not sure if there's a wet spot on the ground, but she's able to get up on her own, which is always a good thing to see. I think she's going to stay in the game. Not sure what happened exactly. We'll have her first substitution of the game. It'll be Kama Lamella actually coming in for Kubo here. She looks to be okay getting off on her own power, which is good to see. As Rabe finds Walker up top. Got two bigs on the elbow. Decides to go for the handoff. Stopped. Foul called on the elbow. That one's going to be on a Yuso, so that'll be her first foul, first team foul as well, and we'll have an inbound down low. Walker's got Thurman outside, driving to the left, a tough finish, can't get it to go. Here come the Urban Knights. Biola does such a great job of helping back on defense. They don't let the fast breaks get to them as they have another foul called here on the ground. They're going to get that one on Kama Lamella. That'll be her first of the game. Urban Knights, they got someone in the corner. Tough floater with the right, no good. Good rebound by Rabe. Walker pushing it up. They got a couple numbers here. Kama Lamella stuck in traffic. Great crossover to the right. Tough finish, no good. That would have been on SportsCenter had that gone in. You know, Radovich is one of those players that, you know, when you're all alone in isolation, you got to watch out because she has got some great moves, especially with that crossover. Foul called on the shot. It's going to be on Walker. It's Ravenga who will make her way to the line, shooting two. We'll have the Urban Knights' first substitution of the game. Looks like it's Christy Ojide checking in for Art U. A couple more substitutions here for Biola. Goldsmith checking in. And then Alexander also in the game for the Eagles. It's a low-scoring game, just as I predicted before, 7 minutes to go. I know it's early, but still, great defense so far from both teams. Cross-court pass to the corner, quick shot. Can't get it to go, and Thurman will collect it. Abby working up top, almost picked away, and it'll stay here. That was Anna Fornells who got a hand on it but just couldn't keep it. So the Eagles will inbound it. They'll find Kim Lamella up top. Got Thurman on the left elbow. Here comes Rabbi with the drive. And they're going to say she took too many steps. You know, that's just a hard one to call, given that she was driving, putting all of her momentum towards the hoop, took a quick stop. It's kind of one of those 50-50 calls that me and Jeff talk about so many times. And unfortunately, just didn't end up in Biola's favor. Thurman picks it away, trying to push it up. Rabbi, good pass to Kamala Lamella. Pump fake over to Thurman. One more pass. Three ball from Alexander, no good. Rabbi hustling and getting the rebound, and I'm going to say she was out of bounds, but either way, you know, as a coach for Biola, you got to be happy with that one. Looked like there was no way that Biola was going to get that rebound, but Rabbi hustled her way over, but was unfortunately out of bounds. So the Urban Knights will inbound, but Biola will press. Are you able to get out of it? Another cross-court pass. Taking it to the baseline and collects her miss. Cleans it up. So Gide, the 6'4 junior. Looks like we had a little bit of a shot clock issue, and we'll reset that, and it'll give the Urban Knights a chance to sub in. It'll be Daugherty, who checks in for the Urban Knights. And Daugherty, haven't seen too much of her so far. She's a grad student from California. And looking at the roster sheet, a lot of these players are from Spain, which is very interesting to see. Kamala Mella tried to get Rabbi from one baseline side to the other and it was picked away, but it'll stay with Biola. This has been a fun one to watch so far. I mean, a lot of defense so far. 3-6. Just about halfway done here with the first quarter. And it's not like both teams are shooting poorly. I mean, Biola shooting 50%. It's just they're unable to get many shots going, and similarly to Art U. Alexander, pass to the corner. They got Rabbi on the extra pass. Floater from the top, but fouled after the shot, and she'll have two. So Jordan Rabbi will make her way to the line. Looking to climb back here. This will be Biola's first few free throws of the game. Rabbi cashes that one in. Second one is good as well. So Rabbi 2-for-2 from the line. 5-6 ball game. Eagles will look to press again. Just gets it by. Kamala Mella almost had it again. Great move on the behind the back. Corner three, no. Good rebound there from Jordan Rabbi. Here they come. It's like we'll have a foul again off the ball. It's going to be called on, it looks like, Anna Fornells. Actually, it'll be Lucia Ravenga who's going to get called for that one on the ground. Looked like Rabby's pass got away, but it was because of a foul. And a few more substitutions. Cabrera checking in for the first time instead of Rabby. And Rabby's done a great job so far rebounding the ball. She'll take a quick break. Double screen up top. Camila Mello, wide open lane, but rejected. And so Chide, I mean, 6 foot four, it's kind of hard to get a shot up on the lane if you're that tall. Thurman trying to help back. Great shot. Gets it to go. It's Lucia Ravenga. Almost a hook shot type shot with the right. Goldsmith gets the screen up top. Alexander on four RU defenders. They got a few numbers. Thurman, the only one back. Eagles able to recover and get back on defense. Cabrera got a hand on it. Trap in the corner. Just a basketball heave pass, but it gets it to go, and that layup is no good. Three players fighting for it. We got a jump ball called. A lot just happened there within the past 45 seconds. We'll have our first media timeout. So 5-8 ball game in favor of Art U. Got ourselves a scrappy battle so far. Jake Macias on the call. If you're just joining us, eaglesbroadcast@gmail.com. Quick media timeout. We'll resume action. The Eagles looking to try to get some more shots up. I mean, 1 for 6 so far on the field. Obviously, it's early, but just the ability to create those shots is something that they're going to look to try to do a little bit more now. Moving on. Eagles pick it off. They got Cabrera in the corner. Great pump fake. Passes it out to Kubo. Wide open. Cash. Alyssa Kubo on the board with a three of her own. That ties the game up at 8. Pass over to the corner. It's going to be a 2, and it doesn't go. Great rebound from Cabrera, but it got away from her. It was actually Radovich, so it will stay with the Knights. It's just hard to get a rebound over somebody who's 6'4". When you look at it, I mean, Cabrera, she's only listed at, it looks like, 5'7 to 6'4". She still out-rebounded that. Rebound! Rabby this time collects it. Cabrera can't find anybody. Hands it off to Walker. And that is going to be an offensive foul on Walker. You're going to say she pushed her off a little too hard. That'll be the 4th team foul for this Eagles squad. So only one left to give after being in the bonus. Eagles continue to go with the full court press. Great crossover, creates some separation. Floater, good. That was a Yuso who's dancing out of danger and creating the shot. Cabrera letting it fly. Rebound, Camila Mella. Gives it back to Cabrera. Got Radovich on the one-on-one. Three ball from Cam Lamella. Hits off the rope, so it's going to be out of bounds. A lot of traffic inside. Jordan Rabe sliding, giving it away. And the Knights will reset. Looks like we'll have a travel. Sifoe charged with the travel. Kimmel Lamella taking it up. Here comes Viola. Looking to get back to where they were. They tied the game up. That one's picked away. They have numbers. 4-on-5. Gives it up. Mid-range. No good. Rebound Art U. Taking it up with the right. Rebound Rabe. See Fowey, who collected the offensive board, just couldn't convert on that short shot. And Rabe looking to take advantage of it. That's Kubo in the corner. Bingo. Lissa Kubo letting it rain today. Tough pass picked away. They got Kemba Lamella. Getting double teamed. Kicked away, so it'll be a kick ball, and it'll stay here with Viola. Few more substitutions. Rabe checking out for Thurman. Ravenga checking back in for Hins. Picked away. Sifawi working on Thurman. Euro step. Called for the foul. Sifoe will have her chance now for two more at the line. That'll be Thurman's first foul. And then the fifth team foul. Sydney Moran also checking in the game now for the Eagles, replacing Cabrera. Can't get that one to go. 1 minute and 30 left on the clock here in the first quarter. Second one can't get it to go either. Kubo pushing it up. Stumbles a little bit but collects it. Eagles will reset up top. Little double screen here. Good pass but picked away. We've been seeing a lot of these passes that have just been on the money. You know, they've been the right idea, but just unable to convert. Great hands there from Art U. And like I said before the last media timeout, it's been a scrappy game so far. Trying to find anybody at this point. They get Thurman. Radovich working down low, creates some space, but picked away at the last second. And a frustration foul looked like there from Radovich. And they are in the bonus, so they'll have a couple shots. It's going to be Ayuso, the sophomore from Spain, who has a chance to extend or to regain the lead, I should say. They're down one right now. And just looking at their field goal percentages from both teams, very similar, both shooting around 30%. Looking to catch some fire. And, you know, I mentioned how good both teams have been defensively. Both teams just unable to convert on some shots and a lot of steals so far this game as well. First free throw is good. Looking to try to regain the lead tie game. And they do. Lamella taking it herself. from coast to coast, but no good. 46 on the clock, passed down low, off the glass, no good. And they're gonna get her for a travel. Sifoe collected her miss like before, and looks like she just had it for too long and took too many steps. Last minute substitution. A couple of them, I should say. It's Hines and then Bruce as well. So plenty of time left for the Eagles to get a shot up. In fact, Art U will also have a chance as well. Got Thurman on the pump fake. Taking it with the left and one. Count it. Jessa Thurman taking it herself. Eagles up one. So Thurman will have her chance now to convert on the and one. A lot of substitutions here coming in the last second again. Fornell's also in the game and replacing Hines and Bruce. Ravenga also in the game. Goldsmith looking to check in for Thurman once she finishes up her free throw. Thurman off the back iron, no good. So Art U looking to try to get the last shot here. There is a 2 to 3 second difference here between the shot and game clock. Interesting to see what they'll do here. They'll probably wait till about 7. Kubo with some pressure up top. 10 on the clock. Sifoe dishes it out down low. 4 to shoot. Gets it up. No good. Rebound Rabe. 3 seconds left and see what she can do. They're just going to hold on to it. So first quarter is wrapped up. 13 to 12. Biola leading things off, and you know, we've seen a lot of lead changes so far, 3 on each team, that is. And excited to see what we'll see in the remaining part of the first half. 13-12, Eagles.
Develop a bold faith for a bright future at Biola University. Experience a top-ranked education that prepares you for a thriving career. Join a Christian community where you belong and can grow in your faith. And be surrounded by Southern California, the ideal place to explore your calling. Apply today to qualify for our largest scholarships ever. Visit biola.edu to find your major or schedule a tour.
So we'll resume action after that short break. Got ourselves a good one so far. 13-12 Eagles after the first quarter. And a little bit of a shot clock issue again. Never turned on. So they'll try to start that one over. And substitution right away for Art U. So Jide checking in for Sifoe. Michelle also in the game for the Eagles. Kubo found Rabe down low. Hop step. Goldsmith extra pass. Alexander for 3. No good. But she collects her own rebound. Michelle over to Kubo. Back to Michelle up top. They'll reset. They got Kubo in the corner for 3. Yes. She cannot be stopped right now. Kubo taking it into her own hands. Eagles pick it away. Pass over to Michelle. Goldsmith back to Kubo for 3, but decides to give it up. They got Rabe, nobody on her. driving through. Michelle for three. She wants one. No good. Rebound, Rabe. Taking it down. Alexander for three. No good. Almost got her rebound again. RU's had enough of it. Here they come. Ravenga working on Michelle. Morrow for three. No. Rebound, Goldsmith. They got Alexander working on three black jerseys. Rabe from the wing. No. It'll go the other way. So a barrage of three-point shots. None of them able to convert except the one from Kubo. Thurman also back in the game this time for Goldsmith. And Radovich also looking to check in, but she'll turn around. And Kubo, 3-for-3 from deep, up to 9 points so far in this contest. Eagles showing some pressure on the press. Aren't you able to break through it? And foul called. So Baker Bruce will draw the foul. And get that one on Michelle. So first personal, first team for her. 4-point game, just a little under 8.5 to go. Baker Bruce working on the Eagles defense and can't find anybody. She'll drive in with the left. Baker Bruce gets it to go. Oh man, was that one pretty. Floating back from the left, off the glass, couldn't ask for anything better. They got the extra pass to Kubo for 4-for-4, no. A little heat check there from Kubo, although she was wide open. Urban Knights looking to try to get a bucket on the board. Driving with the left, rolls around and rattles in. Vera Ayuso. Getting the members roll on that one. Costly mistake there. And it's going to go the other way. And Michelle's trying to plead her case. She's saying that the Urban Knights touched it last, but I can't see it from here. And it's going to go the other way. Eagles still pressing. Tie ball game here. Emma Lamella. Three Eagle defenders on that press, but Baker Bruce gets through it. She's trapped, though. Gets around it in a blocking call on Camila Mella. I'm curious to see if we'll see this full court press from the Eagles in the entire game. You don't typically see that. You usually see that from them in the second half, but we've been seeing that all game long so far. Hines over to Baker Bruce. Back over to Hines, using the high ball screen. Extra pass. Baker Bruce got the back door cut and the finish. We'll see a Ravenga. It's her second bucket of the day. So RU actually regaining the lead again. Uh-oh. Nope, no good. I was going to say. We've had 8 lead changes so far from both teams, 4 from each team. Pass over to the corner, wide open, and a travel called. You don't see that every day when you get a pass in the corner for 3 and you shuffle your feet a little too much. And in fact, that shot went in, but it's not going to count. So Ella will catch a break there and try to see if they can get the 9th lead change of the game. Radovich to the left, fouled after the shot. Looked like it was pretty good there from Baker Bruce. Got a hand on it, but just too much contact. And Alexander will make her way to the line. I appreciate the correction, Lara. It's always nice to know what I'm saying sometimes. I mean, I only get is the sheet, but appreciate any shout-out. You know, if it's correction or if you're just trying to root a player on, that's always appreciated. First one hits the back iron and falls in. Second one rattles in and out, but rebound Viola. Camila Mello, who came up with it, they're going to reset. Over to Rabi in the corner. Backdoor pass to Cabrera. Over to Camila Mello in the corner. Bingo! Nothing but net. Eagles sticking with that full court press. They got Morrow. Baker Bruce. Driving through the baseline. They got Baker Bruce. Trying to take it with the left. Extra pass. Wing corner three. No good. Rebound Rabi. She's been everywhere on the glass today. Nothing new. Thurman over to Rabi. Just too much heat. Gets away from her and they'll turn it over. We've had 8 ties, 10 lead changes. Make that 9. A few substitutions for the Urban Knights, one of those being Rivera Yuso checking back into the game. And Viola's taken almost double the amount of three-pointers that Art Yu's been taking. This leads me to believe that the Urban Knights are more of an inside-looking team. We'll see if that changes in the second half. That three-pointer's no good. Urban Knights only 1-for-8 from 3 so far today. Looking to change that. They got Rabi down low. Nobody on her. Piece of cake. Finish with the right. So Rabi will be up to 4 points so far. Have a foul off the ball. And we'll be on Cabrera. Another media timeout, 22-18, Viola up with 4:45 left to go in the second half. First half.
At Viola, we are neither a bubble to protect children nor a boot camp to train activists. We are a greenhouse for growing students fully as thinking and living Christians who love with discernment. And that means our faculty are here to help you go deeper in formation of the moral and spiritual and intellectual disciplines. This means we want you to become whole persons prepared for the complexity of our world.
We'll resume action. Both teams with 16 rebounds. Jordan Rabi has 8. So 50% of the total team rebounds, and that doesn't surprise me at all. I mentioned it briefly earlier. She does that every game. Baker Bruce again with the left. It's her bread and butter over there with the left. Thurman. Wide open, great pass from Cabrera. Are you breaking the press again? They've been doing a great job of that lately. Has it got another backdoor cut? Rattles out. That's Fornells, who had a shot, just couldn't get it to go. Rabi. Rabi trying to do it herself, gives it up to Thurman. floater with the right, gets it to go. Oh, wow. Jessa Thurman making it look easy. Fouled, is it gonna be an and one? On the floor. Actually not sure yet. It's Baker Bruce who made the bucket, but is it gonna be an and one? No, so it'll be an inbound pass. It was a close call and wasn't really sure until they confirmed it. So that bucket won't count. Baker Bruce wants one. Off the back rim. Alexander slowing things down. Rabe back over to Alexander. Walker back in the game, and we'll have a foul on Anna Fornells. So just too much of a hand check there, and she'll get called for that one. We'll have a substitution. It'll be Lucia Ravenga checking back into the game for Baker Bruce. And then Amelia Doherty also in the game for Anna Fornells. And then another last second sub, Goldsmith in for Thurman. That shot from Thurman was very impressive. It was a Casey Capo shot if you watch any of the men's Biola games, fading back like Dirk Nowitzki. Rabe, long three, no good. Good rebound there from Ojide. Urban Knights want one. No good. A little bit of a cold spell here from both teams. Walker from coast to coast gives it up. Goldsmith, nobody nearer. J.C. Goldsmith gets on the board. Walker steals it. Layup good. In fact, I think that might have been the first time the press actually turned in some points for Biola. See if they can keep that momentum. I'm going to call her for the travel. One too many steps. It was a good move there from Rivera Yuso. But it was indeed the right call. So Eagles starting to poke away here, up 11 with 2 minutes to go. So Thurman will come back from her quick break, checking in for Jordan Rabe. Walker trying to get something to go, but just can't find anything. And she'll lose it, but give it up to Kubo. Thurman up top. Over to Cabrera on the corner. Takes it, but call for a travel. So very similar to what Rivera Yuso just did, and just one extra step, she'll get called for the travel. Lamella checking in for Cabrera. What I've noticed is both teams have been doing an excellent job of protecting the inside. That's why we've been seeing so many turnovers, either from passing or travels, whatever the case is. A lot of good collapsing defensively from both teams. Thought about the three. Gives it up on the backdoor pass, but can't finish. Walker trying to do it herself. Gives it up to Camilla Mella. Goldsmith now up top. Kubo looking to stay on fire. Great pass from Thurman. It's Goldsmith who cleans it up. And that's just that classic backdoor cut that we've been seeing so many times, but that one was just written up to perfection. Ojide now working on Thurman. Deep three ball. Got it. Rivera Ayuso from way downtown. She's up to 10. 1 minute to go in the first half. Goldsmith, she wants another one. She got it. Cannot leave her open. That pass gets away from the Urban Knights, and it'll actually stay here, and it'll be Biola ball from underneath. Sydney Moran now into the game for, looks like, Lena Walker. So Layla Walker will check out, and it'll be Moran who checks into the game. Kim Lamella, deep inbound pass. Over to Goldsmith, Thurman up top. Kim Lamella now, she wants a three, way short. Got some chatter here from the crowd. But it was a good shot. You know, we've been seeing a lot of those open threes, and they have been falling. Eagles up to 38%, 7 for 18 on their threes, so I wouldn't see why you wouldn't want to fire away. Good pump fake. Pops no good. Offensive rebound, Ojide. Driving in the lane, collapsing is Biola, and a charge called. It's Kamala Lamella taking one for the team, and it'll go the other way. Full of substitutions here. Layla Walker into the game, and then looks like that's Doherty checking in as well. Baker Bruce also in the game for Art U. So 21 seconds left to go. Shot clock is off. Eagles will look, try to get the last shot off here. You know, we've been seeing this a lot from Biola. You usually have either Thurman or Goldsmith up top with about 7 seconds to go. It should be Goldsmith. It's going to be both of them, actually. She'll use the screen from Thurman. 7 to shoot. Finish with the right. No good. 4 seconds left to shoot. See what they do, and they'll just lose it, and it'll end the first half. 36-23, Biola in the lead. Great job on the three-pointers from Biola so far. Aren't you looking to heat up from beyond the arc? We'll see what they can do. Welcome back, folks, to the second half here in La Mirada, home of the Eagles. Biola taking on RU and off to a strong start, up 36-23. At the beginning of the first half, we saw plenty of lead changes. I mean, 10 total so far this game, and a lot of great play so far, especially defensively. We'll see if that will stay the same here in the second half. So a lot of action down low and a foul called to kick things off, and she'll make her way to the line. It's Sifawi, it looks like, who collected her own rebound and then drew the foul to get a couple at the line. So they're going to get Radovich on that one. It'll be her first and the first of the team. First free throw, no good. RU's struggling a little bit from the line so far today, only shooting 50%. The biggest thing, though, for this Urban Knights team has been their three-pointers, only 2 for 12 so far in the first half, and it's going to actually stay here after that mishap on the rebound. In fact, it looks like RU's actually out-rebounding Biola right now, 22-20. It's just Jordan Rabe's been everywhere defensively on the boards for Biola. So Radovich will get that rebound. Kubo over to Rabe. Radovich gives it up. Walker from the corner. Good. Lena Walker. Gets her three-pointer that... get her confidence up to begin the second half. That's exactly what the Eagles want. Euro step, deflected but collected. Three-pointer for the Urban Knights, no good. Off the back part of the rim, and it'll go the other way. That was Maddie Morrow, the freshman from New Zealand. So the Eagles will look to try to expand their lead up to their biggest lead of the entire game thus far, up to 16, it looks like. Rabe working down low, gets some separation. Hook shot, no good. Rebound, Urban Knights. Ravenga over to the corner. Rivera Yuso. Three-pointer from Fornells, good. And if Fornells gets the three-pointer to go, and we'll have our first media timeout of the second half, 39-26 Eagles, 8.5 to go. Eagles will kick things off after that media timeout. Elayla Walker jogging along the court for the Eagles. Using a handful of screens. Radovich over on the wing. Great defense from Art U so far. Over to Rabe, wide open in the corner. Bingo. Jordan Rabe up to 7 so far, and Eagles get that one away. Kubo with the steal. Back to Kubo in the corner. Layla Walker. Radovich and Rabe fighting for it. Picked away by Art U. That's Rivera Yuso with the steal. Leading scorer for this Urban Knights team with 10. Driving through the lane with the right hand, no good. Great take from Luisa Ravenga, but just could not convert. Thurman down low with the right. She can't get it to go. Rebound Urban Knights. So a pair of easy buckets just not falling for either team. Deep three, no good. That one was from a mile away and almost had it. Kubo now on the baseline. Rabe wants one from the same spot. She got it. Jordan Rabe having herself a second half. Up to 10 on the game. Eagles continuing to do that full court press that they've been doing all game. Get through it. They want a three of their own, but they can't get it to go. Ball's loose, rebound, and a finish. Lucia Ravenga doing it all herself. It's Kubo now giving it up in the corner. Layla Walker, air ball. Great pass up top, nobody on her, and she'll clean it up. Lucia Ravenga, back-to-back buckets for this RU squad. I talked so many times about how basketball obviously being a game of runs and how important momentum is. This could be one of those turning points for RU. Kubo can't connect. Here they go. Maddie Morrow all alone on a one-on-two. Rabe had a hand on it and deflects it away. Great job there from Jordan Rabe to recognize the pass and to get a hand on it. Ojide checking in the game now for Rivera Yuso. Great pass inside, off the back part of the rim. Ball's loose. Who's going to end up with it? It's going to be Biola. Ball ended up out of bounds, but I'm going to say it was last touch by the Urban Knights. So Layla Walker will take it up for the Eagles, trying to regain some of the momentum that they've lost within the past few minutes. Picked away. Here comes Fornells. Hit it over the extra pass. Sifawi down to Ojide. Back in the corner. Long. But Layla Walker can't hang on to it. It'll stay here. A couple of substitutions. It's going to be Rivera Yuso checking in for RU and then Goldsmith checking in for Biola. Able to find somebody open. Corner three. Long again. Rebound Goldsmith. Thurman working down low. Goldsmith extra pass to Walker. Kubo gives it up. Ojide all alone working on Walker. Taking it to the house and one. Christy Ojide taking care of business. She'll try to convert on the and one. Pair of substitutions here for the Eagles. Camila Mella checking in. Alexander also in, replacing Kubo and Walker. And then Hines also checking in the game for Fornells. So Ojide, like I said before, trying to clean up this and one. Just trying to scrap away at the lead that Biola was able to get mostly in the second quarter. And she converts. No press from RU. Not really sure if they're the type of team that does run the full court press, but we just haven't seen it yet. Might see it towards the end of the fourth. Depending on the score, as Goldsmith gives that one up, but it'll stay here. We'll have another media timeout. So 45-33, Biola, RU having a run of their own, trying to regain momentum.
Develop a bold faith for a bright future at Biola University. Experience a top-ranked education that prepares you for a thriving career. Join a Christian community where you belong and can grow in your faith. And be surrounded by Southern California, the ideal place to explore your calling. Apply today to qualify for our largest scholarships ever. Visit biola.edu to find your major or schedule a tour.
Just overhearing head coach Jesse Clark, his first season as the head coach for this RU team, he's saying, we got to drive the basket. We got to be more aggressive down low and you know, force up those high percentage shots. So we'll see if that is the case here with four, just under five to go. It'll be offensive. Jessa Thurman moving a little bit too much on that high ball screen, and it'll go the other way. Cross-court pass to the corner, baseline drive, and we'll have a foul on the floor. It's going to be on Alexander on the hand check. So a pair of fouls, and you know, just looking at the team fouls from Biola, they're already at 14 fouls, just about halfway done with this quarter. RU hasn't committed a foul all quarter. Got a corner open, but they decide to go for the drive and be a late call foul. I wonder if it's on the ground or up in the air. It's going to be on Goldsmith, but they're in the bonus, so they'll have a couple free throws anyway. You know, if you're RU, you really want to play this to your advantage because time is not your friend considering the score, but if you're able to draw fouls, you'll stop the clock and have a chance to cut in that lead. It's that first one. Rolls out. RU currently 4 for 9, make it 5 for 10 after that one. Tanson through Camilamella in the corner. Can't find anybody in a tough pass. It's going to be loose. Picked away by RU. Can't get the finish to go. It's Hines for three. No good. Rebound, Alexander, and we'll have the first foul of the quarter for RU. It's going to be on Rivera Yuso. It's one of those loose ball fouls that, you know, you see all the time. And have another substitution. Maddie Morrow checking out. It's going to be Baker Bruce checking in. Cabrera also in the game for Biola. So 11-point game, 4 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Cabrera got Rabe in the baseline. Goldsmith, corner three, no good. Good rebound there from Ojide. It's Hines now. Good pump fake. Good floater, but can't convert. Rivera Yuso. Just wiggling through, just can't get anything to fall in. It's been a little bit of a cold spell for her. And although they are good shots, they're just not falling. Camilamella baseline takeaway. What a find there from Cabrera, the backdoor cut. Oh, that's high quality basketball. Baker Bruce gives it up. The three ball from Hines, bingo. That is a huge shot. Now this game has been cut to 10. Thurman wants one. She got it. Both teams letting it fly here. Thurman now up to 12. Eagles still shooting 41% from beyond the arc. Why not let it fly? Corner three, this time the Urban Knights. That one's good. So back to back to back. Three balls, two from Art U, one from Biola. That one was from Rivera Yuso letting one fly. And we have ourselves a 10-point game. 2.5 to go here in the third quarter.
At Biola, we are neither a bubble to protect children nor a boot camp to train activists. We are a greenhouse for growing students fully as thinking and living Christians who love with discernment. And that means our faculty are here to help you go deeper in formation of the moral and spiritual and intellectual disciplines. This means we want you to become whole persons prepared for the complexity of our world.
Stumbles over, picked away by Art U. Comes Rivera Yuso, taking it herself, but picked away. That one from Goldsmith, recovered by Walker. Dribbling through everybody. Kim Lamella now all by herself. Goldsmith to Cabrera. She wants a three. She got it. Delaney Cabrera getting a piece of the pie. Both teams firing away. Confidence from both teams is through the roof right now. Ojide backdoor cut. And one. Count it. Lucia Ravenga. Assisted by Ojide, and we'll have a chance for three. I've been seeing a lot of these backdoor cuts working for both teams now, and it's been really fun to watch. A lot of off-the-ball movement from both teams, and you know, you can't really ask for anything more as a coach. You're doing exactly what I had mentioned before that Jesse Clark had said, you know, drive to the basket, and that's exactly what they've been doing. In fact, it hasn't really been the person with the ball. It's been more players off the ball driving in and getting the bucket. That time from Ravenga. Minute and a half to go, 10-point game. Goldsmith got Radovich. No good. Radovich gets it herself. Three ball. Rattles up and over the backboard, out of bounds. And the Urban Knights will stay with the ball. Handful of substitutions now for Art Yoon. Hines, Baker, Bruce, Ojide checking out. Morrow checking back into the game. Fornells also. Rivera Yuso gets over half court just in time. Corner pass. Fornells working on the baseline. To Ravenga. Over in the corner. Morrow. And it's going to be Moran who got a hand on it, but it looks like Ravenga may have gotten her hand on it after. So Biola will stay with the ball. And that was actually Fornells who last touched the ball. So Cabrera will inbound it for the Eagles. Under a minute to go. Still 10-point game. Picked away. Bad pass. Here comes Ravenga. All by herself. But can't convert. Eagles pushing it up. They got Goldsmith in the corner. Long. Good rebound, but to say offensive. So it's going to be Radovich called for the offensive foul on the rebound, and it'll go the other way. 38 seconds left, and as I had mentioned before, they're in the bonus, so they'll have a couple free throws after that foul. You know, like I mentioned before, it's perfect for RU because you're down and you're trying to waste as little clock as possible, and that's exactly the case here. You have a free possession, basically, and a chance at a couple points without having to waste any of the clock. And Doherty checking back in for Art U. Baker Bruce also in the game again. First free throw, no good. That's Revere Yuso. And Art U only shooting 6 from 12 from the line, 50%. Not ideal in a situation like this, as that one can't go either. So Leila Walker will try to waste most of the clock here. About a 7-second difference here between shot and game clock. Good press here from Doherty. Walker struggling to find anybody. What a foul called on Doherty. That was more just, might as well just get everybody off the court because that was a one-on-one at that point. Kubo now looking to sub in. Everyone has a smile on their face, and I do too. So Rabby will check out. This time the shot clock is off now after that foul, so Eagles will get the last shot here. Walker working on Doherty still. 10 seconds to go. Driving through, stolen away. 7 left to go. They can still get a shot off. They have 3 seconds. Half court shot off the front of the rim. No good. Would have counted had it gone in. 10-point game still, though, working our way into the fourth quarter. Eagles up by 10. We'll see what Art U can do, if they can come back here, if Biola can take it away. We're just moments away of getting the fourth quarter started. I'm overhearing Jesse Clark again. He's saying we gotta keep getting to the line. You know, they're eventually gonna fall in. That's what he's saying, and that's definitely true. I mean, 6 for 14 so far, 42% from the charity stripe. Obviously, that's something that they want to fix here moving into the last quarter, and it's definitely something that they should do. 10 minutes left to go, down by 10. Still plenty of time for Art U. Let's see who wants it more. Eagles not shooting particularly well either from the line, only 60%, although they've only shot 5 free throws. Rabby loses it. Camila Lamella on Morrow. Layla Walker to the corner. Kubo. Air ball. Maddie Morrow. Clearing out traffic. Spin move on Kubo. Over to the corner. No good. We'll have it go the other way. It's going to be, I think it's on Cifaui. Yeah, it is. So go the other way on that offensive foul. Well, both teams just haven't shot particularly well. Eagles shooting a little bit better. And are you only shooting around 30% so far? Layla Walker trying to change that. Rabby from the top. Nothing but net. Jordan Rabby up to 13 on the night. The Eagles, they've been lights out from 3, 41% from beyond the arc. And if you're the Eagles, that's something you got to keep doing if you're in this game moving forward, as that layup's no good. Kubo on the back door, back to Layla Walker. Rabby for back-to-back, yes! Jordan Rabby up to 16 on the night. Walker gets a hand on it, but it'll stay with Art U. We saw just a flash of Jordan Rabe shooting from beyond the arc in the first half. Doing great, and then now heating up here in the second half. Eagles 14 for 31 from beyond the arc. Tough finish with the right, rolls around every part of the rim, but just cannot convert. It was Baker Bruce. Kubo over to the corner, Kamala Lamella. We'll have a foul called on a push. We'll see who that one's on. It's going to be called on Matty Morrow. Can't find anybody. They got Kubo. Barely stays in bounds. Kamala Lamella working on the baseline. Great finish and can't get it to go, but she'll be fouled. So two shots at the charity stripe for Kamala Lamella. And like I mentioned before, they've only shot five free throws, so that'll be their sixth and seventh. They're looking to expand this lead. Having a little bit of a run here, 6-0 run since the beginning of the quarter, and got to credit Jordan Rabe on those two threes. You know, if you're RU, you're looking for one of those plays, and in fact, a breakthrough player. Somebody like Revere Ayuso, who's very confident from beyond the arc, just hasn't been able to get the shots that she typically gets to go in. Still, again, plenty of time for her to heat up here. 8 minutes left to go. Kamala Lamella now up to 7 points after that made free throw. Matty Morrow able to break the press with the pass to Fornells. Revenga. Ojide, and the travel called. So Ojide called for the extra step. Kamala Lamella will check out, Alexander checking in. Layla Walker now. Rabe in the corner. Hands it off to Walker. Picked away, but it'll stay with Biola. That's probably the highlight, I would say, defensively for both teams. Just both teams so scrappy and able to get their hands on the ball. Just unable to get it and remain with possession. They just tip it away. We've been seeing that from both teams. As more scrappy play ends up in the hands of Morrow. Ojide now to Fornells, pushing it up, clearing traffic. It's Revenga, back to Morrow. Eurostep, Revenga gives it up to Ojide, but not before foul's called. That'll be the first team foul for Biola. Gonna get Alyssa Kubo on the hand check. That'll be her first. Morrow stuck in the traffic, and we'll have a jump ball. Great job there from Kubo to recognize that that ball was loose. But it'll stay with Art U. Possession arrow will obviously change. Morrow, wide open in the corner. Nobody was on her, and she'll let that one go a little long. Picked away, though, by Rivera Yuso. Fakes the pass and lets it fly for the layup. A great move. Reminds me of Manu Ginobili, who's stutter-stepping his way around the rim. Same thing there from Rivera Yuso. Great crossover there from Walker, but can't finish. Two-on-two situation. Thurman gets back on defense. Rivera Yuso wants a triple. She got it. There it is. A little fist bump there from Rivera Yuso, and that's exactly what they need, and it's what I talked about before, just having somebody on the team who can catch a spark with confidence. That one might be the turning point. Walker working through. Oh, my goodness, blowing by everybody in the easy finish. Showing off the speed. She's up to 7. Behind the back move by Ravenga. Gets some separation. Morrow over to Fornells. All alone working on Thurman. Thought about the three. Decides to give it up. Couple pump fakes there. Corner three from RU. No good. Alexander now with the rebound. This has been a very high quality shots from both teams, especially from RU within the past few minutes. Rabe wants another one. No good. Rebound Ravenga. Gives it up. Rivera Yuso working on Walker. A little bit of a mismatch here. Taking it down. Ajide can't recover it, but it'll be off Walker, so it'll stay here. Again, more of that scrappy basketball that I talked about. Everybody's getting a piece of it. Morrow will check out. Hines will check in. Kubo will check out. Cabrera will check in. And then Camila Mello will check in, and Alexander will check out for her. I'd like to see more of the high ball screens or just on ball screens from either team. We haven't seen too much of that in this quarter. Extra pass. Thought about the deep three, decides to take it in and cleans it up with the floater. Rivera Yuso trying to take over here. 5 minutes to go. She's up to 20 points on the day. Cabrera wants a corner three. No good. Nobody's on her. Wide open, but she can't get it to go. It's Fornells who whiffed it. Jordan Rabe again. No good. Great rebound from Ojide. Ooh, shifty with the behind the back corner three ball. No good. Pair of substitutions here, but we'll have ourselves a media timeout. 63-50 will stay here. 4 minutes left to go, and you know, a lot of rebounding here from Biola, specifically in this fourth quarter. Now leading in that category, 32-25. We've been seeing a lot of those high percentage shots that I've been talking about, but they just haven't been able to go through. It's been Rivera Yuso who's trying to take this game over. Again, like I just said, up to 20 points, doing her part, trying to get more teammates involved, but it just seems like right now they're not catching the spark that they need in order to come back and win the game. Right now they're only shooting 30% from field goal percentage, and that's 19 for 62. In fact, RU, they've been taking 10 more shots in Biola, but they just haven't been able to get any to go through, and what I think it is, it's their three-pointer percentage. 6 for 26 from beyond the arc, and you know, we just haven't seen that spark like I just mentioned. Biola led this game 70% of the time, and the first half, this game was really close. We saw a handful of lead changes, but it was Biola who seemed to want the ball more, and that's reflecting on the score so far. So here we go, about to resume action here in the fourth quarter. Are you trying to get something to go? As they find Rivera Yuso up top. Driving through, no good. Just driving through a lot of players. Eagles looking to slow down the pace and waste the clock. Goldsmith on the high ball screen. Cabrera now. Up to Radovich, rejected. Collected by Radovich, and a foul was called. So a lot of action so far in this fourth quarter. It was Cabrera who had it, but a great rejection there. I think it was from Ravenga. So it'll be Radovich, actually, who collected a rebound and will be at the line. One rolls in and out. Eagles looking to heat up here from the free throw line. So far, not so good. 5 for 8. Make it 5 for 9. Foul called on, I believe, yep, Cabrera. on that rebound. So it will go to the Urban Knights. You know, if you're the Eagles right now, you just don't want to foul. Fouling's probably the last thing that you want to do. You don't want to stop the clock. It is your friend in this scenario. Fornells gives it up to Ojeda. Trapped on the double team. Tough pass, and it's going to go to Biola. So Fornells with a hard foul, but it's going to go to the Eagles. Camilamella with the inbound pass over to Walker. We'll keep things rolling here in the fourth. Foul called on the ground. It's going to be on Rivera Yuso. That's her third, fifth team foul, so they're now in the bonus. Let's see if Radovic can convert after missing a pair in the last attempt. First one's good.
Hey, finish your block. Finish. Let's go.
That one rattles in and out. Almost rebounded from Biola, but it's going to be Rivera Yuso who collects the board. She's up to seven rebounds. Foul called on Walker. Rivera Yuso has really impressed me so far, shooting 35% from the field, 3 from 8 from 3. 20 points on the night. Can't really ask for anything else if you're Art U. Still some time left on the clock. We'll see if they can make the most of it. Long pass and then another long pass, but nothing doing for the Urban Knights. Venga on the baseline, gives it up. Hines wants a long three off the back of the rim. Jessa Thurman rips it away and collects the board. Layla Walker on the baseline gets fouled, so she'll make her way to the stripe. I'm going to call that one on Lucia Revenga. Not really sure what happened. I wonder if it was a bump or a hand check, whatever the case is, it's going to be a foul, and Layla Walker will have a chance for two. Walker cashes that one in, and a pair of substitutions here for Art U. It'll be Maddie Morrow checking in. Actually, we'll have a little bit of a halt for those substitutions. Not really sure why. Let's see, Fowey and Morrow. And they'll check in now. Ojeda, Hines checking out. Walker now up to 9 points on the night after that made free throw. 16-point game, just under 3 minutes to go. You know, the Eagles are still rolling with this full court press. You typically wouldn't see that given the circumstances, but either way, high intensity play. Able to give it up to Fornells. Dancing through. She wants one, but she can't get it. It was Rivera Yuso with a deep three. Camilamella all alone in the corner. She's got the baseline picked away. Got to hustle now if you're the Urban Knights. Clearing traffic, driving to the right, short. Layla Walker slowing things down. Picked away, Lucia, which was Rivera Yuso. See if she does behind the back, dishes it off and gets it to go. Anna Fornells cleaning up the change. Backdoor cut over to Kubo. To the corner, Rabe with the extra pass. Bingo! Jordan Rabe now up to 19 points on the game. She's been the X factor so far, especially later in this game, especially in the third quarter. In fact, the fourth quarter, too, she's been lights out. 69-52, minute and a half to go. Jake Macias on the call.
Develop a bold faith for a bright future at Biola University. Experience a top-ranked education that prepares you for a thriving career. Join a Christian community where you belong and can grow in your faith. And be surrounded by Southern California, the ideal place to explore your calling. Apply today to qualify for our largest scholarships ever. Visit biola.edu to find your major or schedule a tour.
A minute and a half left to go for Art U. See if they can finish strong here. Maddie Morrow, corner three. Back part of the rim. It seems to be the miss for this Art U team, just that back rim. Might just be one of those games, you know, you see that very often. Depends on the game, and looks like we'll have another shot clock issue, I believe. And we'll have a handful of substitutions coming in for the Eagles. Michelle checking in. It looks like a whole new starting five for this Eagles squad. Camden Miller checking in. LaBerge checking in as well. Esther Nam checking in. And then Sydney Moran. In fact, we got ourselves a shout-out for Esther. Hawaii says happy birthday to Esther, and happy birthday to her. See what she can do here. A minute left to go. Picked away. And long on the layup, and it'll go to Biola. Now, how about a happy birthday bucket? We'd love to see that, wouldn't we? Michelle taking it to the corner. Got it. Sydney Moran. Letting it fly from beyond the arc and just adding fuel to the fire. Up 20 points now with under a minute to go. Got Baker Bruce driving in. Great finish and gets it to go. I would like to see Baker Bruce get a little bit more involved on those interior shots as of another timeout called and another substitution. It's going to be Hope Weber checking into the game, replacing Miller. Michelle collects it up top. Still time for that happy birthday basket. Let's see if she can get it. Ball swinging around. Over to the baseline, great pass. Everyone's smiling out there. 8 seconds left to shoot. Almost gets it to go, offensive rebound and a foul. Abigail LaBerge will have her chance to collect a couple at the line. Shot clock obviously off. LaBerge will have her chance for two more at the line. 8 seconds to go. Gets that one to go. So LaBerge will get on the board with her first point of the game. And that one will rattle in and out. I think Art U will just hold on to this one, and that will wrap things up. 73-54, Eagles take care of business. There's a lot to talk about so far in the game in general, but it was really Jordan Rabe who was lights out. 5 from 9 from 3, and also Layla Walker doing what she does best in facilitating the offense. Kubo also doing a great job, 50% from beyond the arc. In fact, we'll have ourselves a post-game interview in just a second. But overall, great job from the Eagles. I wonder who we're going to get on this interview. I guess we'll find out. Looks like we'll have Jordan Rabe on in just a second. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Awesome. So, Jordan, you did great. You were lights out from beyond the arc, 5 for 9. Talk to me a little bit about that. Where was the confidence coming in today?
Honestly, it was all from my teammates. They were cheering me on. I missed two really early, and they just told me to keep shooting and just keep my head up. And then were finding me in open spots, and really they did all the hard work. So.
Yeah. So you guys were passing the ball great. Obviously, you were doing excellent from the boards as you typically do. Talk to me a little bit about that, going up against a player like Ojide, 6'4". How are you able to out-rebound somebody of that size?
Yeah, we just came into the game kind of knowing they give up 40% O-boards, so our goal was to just crash the boards hard on offense and then protect the rim defensively. So really it's just a mindset. I know Jessa and I came in there a couple times in the game, and our whole goal was just to rebound as much as we could. So mindset was the biggest thing.
Awesome, yeah. Mindset was great and a great win. Congratulations. Great job. You did everything you could.
Thank you so much.
So again, a great victory here for the Eagles, and we'll see if they can continue that momentum moving forward. We'll have a pair of games coming up here for the women's squad as they handle business against Academy of Art. They'll take on Dominican on December 18th here at Chase Gymnasium. Hawaii Hilo also on December 30th. And then Chaminade at home on January 1st, and I'll be here for all those games. Jake Macias signing things off here. Eagles taking care of business. We'll have the men's play in just a few minutes.